Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me.
Good morning. I'm Lily.
And I'm Sophie.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Today's day is Thursday, February 14th, 2013.
The weather today will be a high of 58 and a low of 36 with sunny skies.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the singing of the National Anthem.
Next, we will pause for a moment of silent reflection.
Attention, slow pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now to our interviewers, Brianna and Mo.
And our special guest, Mr. Singer.
Hi, I'm Mo.
And I'm Brianna, and this is our special guest, Mr. Singer.
Good morning, Mr. Singer.
Good morning, how are you? Happy Love Day, everybody. Good morning, GBTV crew. Good morning, Gators. Happy Thursday. The sun's out. I heard Lean On Me as our intro. Very nice selection. So that just lets me know that we're going to have a great Gator Day. We'll start off our day with the lunch menu. Brianna, if you would.
Our lunch for today is...
Happy Love Day. We're going to move on to the wondrous word. You ready? I'm leaning on you for the wondrous word. What's our wondrous word?
Bevy.
Very good. Bevy. Our wondrous word, bevy, comes to us courtesy of Jasmine Hartley, fourth grader in Ms. Brown's class. She found the word bevy in the book entitled Nerds. Any of you read that title before, that book you have? Is it good? Mm-hmm. Did you finish it?
No.
Okay. Oh, did you finish it?
I read the title.
Okay. Okay.
We're inside.
Okay.
Me too.
All right. So, Jasmine found the following sentence in the book entitled Nerds, using the word bevy. He had a bevy of skills that served him well, including defusing landmines, driving tanks, and breaking codes. He had a bevy of skills that served him well, including defusing landmines, driving tanks, and breaking codes. The way the word is used in the sentence, Jasmine feels as if bevy means great. Jasmine feels that bevy means great. I'm wondering if the protagonist in the story is the person that they're describing here with all the bevy of skills, and why would these particular skills serve, how would these particular skills serve him in this book? Maybe Jasmine will be able to enlighten me. But again, Jasmine feels as if and bevy means great. Any ideas of what you think the word means?
A lot of skills.
Maybe a lot?
Like lots of genres.
Lots of genres. Very good. Okay. The definition for bevy means a large group or collection. So the character in this story has a wealth of skills that I'm assuming serves him well in this book some sort of way. Hopefully Jasmine will be able to enlighten me. Certainly you need no assistance with breaking the codes of meeting the expectations of being safe, respectful, responsible, and resourceful. We have a nice sunny day in which you can use the opportunity to do so. Make sure that when you're in the hallways, you're staying to one side. Make sure that you are using correct manners when you're in the restrooms. Make sure that even in the lunchroom, you're being respectful to one another and join your conversation with your neighbor and taking care of what you need to do once you're done with your lunch. At carpool, I've been out in the parking lot working carpool, and I always look to see if there's like it's almost like music when carpool flows nicely and well. I can always tell if you're doing your part by seeing if we have a number of cars pulled over, because that stops the flow of carpool. So that lets me know that maybe we're not doing all we can on our end of the gym. So make sure you do your part, because I can tell, like I said, we end almost by a certain time if we get it right. And I know that you're doing your part when we do. So make sure that you bear that in mind for later on today. This is going to be a great Gator Day. Enjoy the sunshine. And we're going to try the lunch menu yet again. Happy Love Day. Brianna, take it away.
Our love for today is scrambled eggs, whole grain biscuit, sausage link, baked potato rounds, tomatoes, rosy applesauce, turkey sauce cheese sandwich, milk, ketchup, fresh fruit, and canned assorted fruit.
Gators, as you're making your lunch selection, make sure that you select one vegetable and one vegetable, one fruit in order to get a complete meal. And also bear in mind the announcements we shared earlier about being respectful in the lunchroom and taking your tray to the receiving line. Always remember, we want to cut down on that gridlock traffic. We want everyone to be able to enjoy their lunch. Hope you all have a great Gator Day. That's all I have.
Now back to our anchors, Lily and Sophie.
Yes, happy Love Day.
Have a great Gator Day. Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Love Day.
Thank you, Mr. Singer.